Hi guys, this is Kian from Komu. Welcome back to our channel. Today with me here is the Proton X50 flagship model. Today I'm going to talk about the Proton's ICC versus Komu Assist. So here are the four main problems of the Proton X50's ICC system. Firstly, the lane keep assist will only depend on the lane line to center your vehicle in the lane. Secondly, the inactive lane keep control may actually sway your car out of the lane, either oversteer or understeer. And thirdly, the hands-on wheel alert will repeatedly warn the driver for every 10 seconds. And last but not least, the inconvenience of pressing the resume button or the gas pedal to resume the auto follow of the low speed traffic. Okay guys, the first problem that we realized with Proton's ICC is the dependency of the lane keep feature on the lane line. So if let's say the lane line is faded, or when there's no lane line at all, as a Malaysian, we know that, you know, there are many scenarios that could happen on a Malaysian road, right? So when the lane line is not there, the lane keep of the Proton's ICC will totally deactivate itself, and it will show an orange icon like now. And even, yeah, the lane line is still solid. So there are always very, sudden changes of solid lane line, faded lane line, sometimes even, both sides that are clear where there are no lines, no line marking, right? So this, at this kind of moments, right, the Proton's ICC could just suddenly, go away and then come back, go away, come back. So this kind of user experience where we think that it could actually even take away your inconvenience or your peace of mind that you intend to have when you turn the Proton's ICC on. Yeah. Okay guys, so with Komu Assist, what we'll do on the lane keep is that we don't only detect the lane line and keep your car within the lane, because the Bookup Pilot AI itself, it is able to find field information on the road to act as the indicator for its lane keep. So for example, like now, although the left side of the lane is faded just now, but then we will still rely on any side of the line marking that is present on the road. Okay, so even if both sides does not have lane line, we will actually follow the lead car. Or if let's say you are on the left side of the road or right side of the road, we will actually follow the divider or the border. So with the intelligence of Bookup Pilot AI, we can actually, even when lane lines are not there, or even when we are on Jalan Kampong, it can actually still detect the borders very well and maintain your vehicle in the lane. Okay, if let's say there is no lane line and the border is not clear, or the road is too wide that the camera can't capture, what the system will do is that it will then prioritize the lead car. So imagine if let's say the lead car is performing a cornering, our system will not directly point towards the car and drive towards it. What it will do is that it will actually remember how the lead car actually performed the cornering, and it will also follow the path of the cornering. Yeah, so that is what an AI software can do. Okay, and if let's say both lane lines and the lead car are absent, then the system will actually look for borders or the shape of the whole road, and it will sit itself in the center until any lead car or lane line reappears on the road. Yeah, so with that, we can be very confident in Komu Assist lane keep feature. And as you can see now, all this while I've not been holding the steering wheel. I mean, this is just to demo the capability of the system. But then you can see that even when lane lines are fading, or when there's no lead car, or when there's a very sudden turning, Proton X50's steering is still very capable of doing all these turns. Okay guys, so the second problem that we realized with the Proton's ICC lane keep feature is the lack of confidence, even though when the lane line is solid. So as you can see now in the meter, I have the ICC on, And yes, it is detecting the both and the left and the right lane, the light lines. And that icon should be in green color, which means it's in control. But then we can still feel a bit of ping pong, which means that actually the car is bouncing left and right within the lane, between the lines. And sometimes even at cornerings, it could perform understeer, which means the steering control turn less than intended, or even like for example like this, or even oversteer, which means the steering control, it turns more than intended. So this will not keep your vehicle in the lane line. And you can see now, actually the icon has turned orange, which means that the lane control is no longer active. So if let's say this, even with very solid lane lines, as you can see, so imagine if let's say with the lane keep feature on, but then all this could still happen, it will be actually very unpredictable, which means the driver wouldn't be able to actually fully trust the system and navigate them throughout, you know, a long stretch of distance while you are on a long distance travel or even in traffic jam, right? Okay guys, and with Komu Assist, regarding the Lane Keep Assist feature, we are very confident when Komu Assist is being plugged onto a Proton X50. Why is that so? It's because one thing is because of the intelligence of the Bookout Pilot software, and secondly is because of the strength, the steering torque strength of this car model itself. So when there is very good detection and when there's very strong steering control, this car can basically perform almost all kinds of cornering, even on a main road that does not have a very wide road. Like for example here, we are going to perform a cornering at, okay, like we are at a speed of 65 km per hour now, but you will see that there is no oversteer or there's no understeer. We just perform a very nice cornering. So why is the system able to do so is because of the detection as well as the intelligence. Okay, and with our Lane Keep, you will never see ping pong or the non-performance of the Lane Keep, because like I mentioned just now, right, the stock could sometimes just pop out an orange icon and then the Lane Keep feature will be turned off. That is basically due to the system not being able to detect the lane, although it's quite solid there. But with our system, like I mentioned just now in the first solution, even though when the lane line is not there, it's faded, or sometimes it's just the border, the divider, we are confident because of the detection. So with this kind of confidence and reliability of the Lane Keep, as the driver myself, I can feel that I can trust the system more. I can be more relaxed at different scenarios, for example in a slow moving traffic or even during high speed when I know that you know, things are more certain, cars have a distance between them and then the road is wider. So at those kind of scenarios, you can really see Komu Assist shine in a Proton X50. Yeah. Okay guys, the third problem that we realized with the Proton's ICC Lane Keep feature is the hands-on steering wheel alert. So by default, the system will give you two warnings before it fully deactivates itself, right? Ah yeah, as you can see now, it happened the first time. And if I continue to not hold the steering, there should be another. Okay, self ACC deactivated. So as you can see now, we think this kind of, you know, sudden deactivation or the hands-on wheel alert coming out, it can actually really not give you a lot of convenience if let's say you are already very confident with the system and you know that you are in a, you know, wide road or very low speed traffic. But that just keep happening. So imagine you will have to always pull the steering, and even in a traffic jam, you will always have to adjust, you know, touch the steering a bit. So that take away the convenience. So what I have to do is that I will have to re-engage again if let's say that happened. Yeah. Okay, with Komo Assist, we have replaced the hands-on steering wheel alert to be our driver monitoring. So what it does is that there's no longer beeping sound, there's no longer sudden deactivation. Oh yeah, and by the way, our system will never self-disengage and it is always 100% in control, actively controlling your steering to maintain it in the lane. So with driver monitoring, we are using a camera with another AI software to detect the direction of the driver's face as well as eyes to make sure that the driver is still focused while the system is engaged, so that we do not abuse the system, right? And that is our redundancy layer. For example, if I were to act like I am playing my phone or I were to be micro-sleeping, the system will make noise and it will also come out with a visual warning to show a banner to ask the driver to pay attention. And if, let's say, I were to continue to not get focus on the road, it will actually go into a siren mode where then even at that moment, if the driver look back up, it will never disengage. I mean, the warning will still be there. So the only way for the driver to stop that is to actually reset the system by stepping on the brake and then just, you know, re-engaging again. And at that moment, no matter what, our system Bookout Pilot will never disengage, because that will be only more dangerous if, let's say, the driver is already not able to focus and we still disengage the system. So what we'll do is instead, we'll keep the system engaged and your car will slowly slow down to a standstill, okay? So that is our safety. So back to the benefits of us, you know, replacing hands-on steering alert to this DM cam is because we think that that will give us truly a better hands-free convenience in certain scenarios. For example, in a slow moving traffic where we are able to actually perform some other minor tasks like answer some calls, reply to some emergency texts, or even do some snacking while we are in a 1 hour jam. So that is one thing, as well as during a high speed cruise, you will understand that if, let's say, sometimes in terms of safety, some of our users, they could be micro-sleeping or they could be dozing off. But at those kind of scenario, our system is 100% in control, and also paired with the driver monitoring, it can actually make sure that the driver has enhanced safety, and because of the system keeping their vehicle in the lane. Okay guys, the fourth problem that we realized is the auto resume of the ICC. So as you can see now, we are in a slow moving traffic scenario at below 10 km per hour. If the stock system were to break down to 0 km per hour, the brake will actually hold there and it will not auto resume by itself. So you can imagine if, let's say, you are in a very bad traffic, and every single time that you come down to 0 km per hour, you will have to push the resume button or step on the gas pedal to actually resume the ACC. So now we are actually stopped at a red traffic light. So just to, you know, show you that how does the auto resume that require the driver to actually push on the button. So now the front car is moving already, but then we'll have to push on reset. And yes, I just got honked. So you can imagine in a very slow moving traffic, if, let's say, this were to happen, you as a driver will kind of feel frustrated because you have to always manually, you know, do that thing if, let's say, it's in a traffic jam scenario, not at a traffic light, right? So this will actually take away the convenience of, you know, the Proton ICC in a low speed traffic, and with the inconvenience of the steering, with the inconvenience of the auto resume, you can't really do much with Proton ICC turned on in a traffic jam. Okay guys, with Komo Assist, as you can see now, I can be more relaxed in slow moving traffic, and now it's after work hours, so you can see that the low speed auto follow is a lot smoother with Komo Assist. And you can see that if, let's say, we were to stop at a standstill later, it will also not require me as the driver to click step on the pedal or click on the button to let it auto resume. And we have also configured the ACC to actually be always moving slightly. I mean, like, instead of trying to follow the distance on a very strict manner, then go to a standstill and then restart again. So what we do is we'll try to make the ACC always trying to make the car, you know, traveling slowly so that, you know, the wheels are rolling. So that actually imitates a more natural way of how human drive. Also, because of the sensitiveness of our steering control, it is able to very accurately follow the car in front. And you can see, even the slightest degree, it will actually help to maintain your car in the lane. So as compared to the original lane keep assist at a slow moving traffic, the driver has to, you know, like, always pull the steering. So you don't have to do that anymore with Komo Assist. So this is the real low speed follow traffic jam assist. So as you can see now, if let's say we know that this area has no motorcycles cutting lanes or no cars coming into our lane, then we can be more relaxed, can enjoy the music a little bit. Your foot can be more relaxed as well. So we don't have to always be ready and be aware of the traffic in front, and our system will be able to help you navigate through the traffic jam. Thanks for watching our video. Comment down below what is the next car model that you want to see, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.